This is our next exercise, exercise 1.3 on LED and resistor. So in this exercise, we'll look at what is LED, what is resistor, and why they are important to use together. So again, make sure that you are on the circuits section and then create new circuits. If you notice, your exercise 1.1 and 1.2 should be still in your account. So click create new circuits. And then remember that you need to go to the top left corner to key in the exercise. So in this time, we have exercise 1.3. Okay, so again, since we'll be using the Arduino from now on, so we drag one Arduino over here. If you return to the top on the list, you will notice that there's resistor and LED just over here. So these two components are the component that we will be using in this exercise. So you drag one resistor in and then one LED. Okay, you can change color of LED to any color that you want. Okay, so just change to any one. LED is different than light bulb. Light bulb, it doesn't have polarity, which means the positive and negative are the same, so you can connect it either way, but LED is not. The full name of LED is light emitting diodes. In these words, okay, light emitting means that it emits light, it shows you light, it gives you lights, and then diodes is actually an electronic part that only allow the electricity to flow in one direction. To recognize which part is the positive, which part is negative, you can actually point your mouse pointer onto it. It will show you cathode and anode. Okay, we have to connect anode to the positive bit, which is the 5 volts, and then cathode has to connect to ground. Okay, but before that, we need to deal with the resistor first. So in this resistor, when you click on it, you can rotate it like what I did. What you need to do, very important, is that you have to change the resistance value first. Resistor is something that used to absorb extra power, electrical power, that you don't need for your device. For example, in this case, we have LED. LED cannot run through with anything that have very high current or very high voltage. So basically, we need a resistor to help it absorb some of the power. So just now I already say that LED has positive and negative. Let's try to connect it without the resistor first. So on this LED, how to differentiate which one is the positive other than using your mouse pointer is to look at the shape. Okay, the straight one is always the one that have to connect to GND, and then this part that has a bend is the one that you need to connect to the 5 volts. Let's say we try to connect it to 5 volts now, and then the other side, the cathode, which is the straight one, we connect it to ground, GND. When you press start simulation on the top right corner, you will notice that it shows you a symbol that say that the LED will explode. Okay, it's basically because the electrical power is too high than what the LED can sustain. So that when you actually plug it on like this, the LED will be broken. So like I say, we need resistor to help absorb part of the electrical power. So let's say we put this here. Okay, we need to change the resistance value. For LED, the resistance value appropriate is 200 ohms. Okay, you have to change the number to 200 and make sure that on the right side you click and then change it to ohm, not K, not M, not other thing. Only this one with this symbol. This symbol is ohm. After you change it to ohm, then you can directly connect it to one side of the LED. It doesn't matter whether you connect it on this side or the other side, as long as once you complete the whole circuits. Okay, the resistor is part of the circuits. Okay, as long as the resistor is part of the circuits and the LED is connected to it, then once you press start simulation, the LED will light up. The value of the resistor actually depend on a lot of calculation, but we'll leave at it at this moment. So once you can connect the resistor to the LED, set the resistor value to the correct value and light up the LED, then this exercise 1.3 is done. Today's conclusion, instead of light bulb, we more often use LED, which stands for light emitting diodes, when handling electronics. LED has polarity, which means it will only allow current to flow in one direction. The straight side of the LED, which is actually the shorter side when you have the actual object, has to be connected to the ground, which is DND, while the squiggle side, which is the longer side, has to be connected to the positive, which is usually the 5 volts or 3.3 volts. LED cannot draw power directly from Arduino Uno because the power is too high for it to handle, so we will need a resistor to draw some of the power away. That's all for today. Thank you.